like to understand a little bit better about the chorus of the .ONG.NGO and what has the organization been doing to increase this this importance and this reach.
Well, the internet is about to go through some pretty dramatic changes, with hundreds of new names coming in and new spaces coming into the internet. And so what we are doing at Public Interest Registry is creating a unique space for the global ONG community. Two domain names, .ONG, .NGO, together with a directory and a portal and the opportunity for that community to have their own unique space and to tell their story worldwide.
And how is your organization involving with ISPs to increase this work?
Well, we're talking to anyone and everyone who can help us get the message out to the global ONG community that this new space is coming in the internet exclusively for them. ISPs are often the people who work directly with ONGs, helping them to secure a domain name, build a website, join the internet. And so we think they're an important group that can help us tell that story.
What is the main proposal, the main objectives to create and to organize this .ONG?
No, our main objective is really to help the community. We're a nonprofit ourselves, so we understand those motivations. And we want to make sure that every ONG or NGO around the world has a chance to be part of the internet, be online, tell their story, find partners, find donors, and invite others to their mission and work. And that's what we're all about.
And regarding today, ONG, do you do some work to fiscalize if they're really non-profit and if the company is fulfill all the requirements to be and to go to demand and find the .ONG?
Yes, part of the important aspect of this is it's a space for genuine ONGs and NGOs. So you have to be validated. You'll fill out a short questionnaire, potentially provide us with documentation, and that's our job to, and what we've been building for the last few years is a process so we can ensure that only genuine NGOs have the chance to register their name. And equally, we're going to invite the community to help us keep the space exclusive for genuine NGOs. So there's a challenge process. If you see someone there, we know we won't be perfect. Help us with that process, and we've built ways in which you can.
Could you talk a little bit about the work that has been doing in Brazil to involve this community and to engage them?
Well, this is my second trip to Sao Paulo, and I've met with a number of ONGs over the last few days, as I did a year ago when I was here. We have partners who live here in Brazil. It's one of our key markets where we see a huge community, 750,000 ONGs operating here in Brazil, and only a small fraction even have a presence on the internet. And so being in our portal, putting their profile page, describing their mission is a really important first step for them. And so we're putting a lot of work into doing outreach, sponsoring conferences here in Brazil, as we did ONG Brazil last year in November, all about getting our message out.